Welcome. All right. So I'm going to give you just a quick introduction to SSI so you can understand if you haven't seen the book or you don't know the topic very well. We will make sure you have a quick understanding. And then in the Q&A, we can go as deep into the subject as you'd like. So when you hear the term digital wallet, what comes to mind? And for many people, when they think of a wallet, they think of, hey, that's what I use to store money to go pay something. So this will be the digital version of that. And especially they think about using it with a blockchain or cryptocurrency of some kind. And that is a very popular form of digital wallet. But if you think about what we use our physical wallets for today, the ones we carry in our pockets, of course we use them for money. But the other thing we use them for is identity. This is how we prove who we are or what we have access to. So having a digital form of a wallet with digital credentials that we can use online the same way we do offline is a big breakthrough. It's going to simplify everything we need to do online. It will start by replacing usernames and passwords, which are all of us have, that are so hard to deal with, and turn it into a single tap authentication that you can use on your phone, on your tablet, on your laptop, in your car, and even in person at a bank or a store. This will make your experiences, every place you're interacting online, simpler and smarter and more secure, and also more private. It will allow companies to conform with privacy regulations and keep less information in centralized databases. And it will give everyone the ability to carry their digital credentials with them wherever they need them for banking, for healthcare, for travel, for school. And particularly when it comes to banking and finance, it will allow individuals to compile the information they need for a bank account or for credit or for insurance once and use it every place they need it. That's called know your customer. So these digital credentials and the use of SSI digital identity wallets is already happening. We have a number of examples in the book. This slide gives you examples of ones that either myself or Evernim Noah Vast or our partners are directly involved in delivering with credit unions, which are financial cooperatives using a membership, digital membership card, KYC with banks in the UK. Maybe the best known is what's called the IATA Travel Pass, which is a digital credential you can get of your COVID health status in order to get on an international airline flight. And there are over a dozen airlines that are now doing that today. The largest healthcare provider, one of the largest in the world, the NHS in the UK, in Britain, is using digital credentials for doctors and nurses to move between hospitals and healthcare facilities and very quickly prove, I am a doctor, I am a nurse. And we'll talk more about how in Europe, it is now going to be a national standard throughout Europe to move to digital identity wallets with identity credentials issued by your government in Europe. So to put this in perspective, and the first chapters of the book explain this, this is the third and newest evolution of digital identity on the internet. We went from centralized systems where everyone logs into the same system and all the information's in one centralized database. Next, we said that's too painful, it's too hard. It's all these usernames and passwords. So then we went to what are called federated systems, where you can log into one system and it will turn around and help you log in and share a little bit of profile information with other systems. So whenever on the internet you press a button to say log in with Facebook or log in with Google or log in with Apple, that is a federated identity system. But with SSI, we can go fully decentralized. Everyone can have their own digital wallet and obtain the credentials that you qualify for and then use them anywhere you want, just like we do with physical wallets today. So this is why it is such a large shift in how we're going to use the internet. And a good part of the book is about that shift. This slide summarizes all the places in the world, the different SSI projects that are going on. And I'm not going to take time to go into the detail, but as you can see, it is every place in the world, including, of course, in Korea, Singapore, New Zealand, Australia. It is a worldwide movement. And I want to especially stress that in Europe, about 9 months ago, the European Union made a decision to install an entire infrastructure across the member, what they call the member countries, member states, in the European Union, and standardize how digital wallets and SSI will work across all those member states. So if you're a citizen of France and you get a digital identity wallet that the French government approves, you can now get a credential of being a French citizen, and you can go and use that across the European Union. Now, I saw a hand just go up. So if there's a question about that right now, I'm happy to take that. I don't know if that how easy that is. I would have to have it interpreted though. I wonder how I tell you what, I think I'm going to have to wait until I'm finished with the slides, and then we'll then I'll be able to take. So please hold that question until we're finished, and then we'll go into Q&A mode. Okay, so anyway, you get my point about Europe. Now, a couple points about why is SSI so powerful? What is the big distinction here? And I want to give you just a couple examples. This is an example, again, from the European Union of how federated identity works today. If you are a French citizen, as I said, or in this case, in the Netherlands, if you're a citizen, you go to a service provider and it connects, and you have if you are a citizen of the Netherlands, your country will basically say, oh, I will tell the country of Ireland or the country of Germany that yes, you are a citizen of the Netherlands. But these systems all have to talk to each other, and this is fairly complex. In fact, it involves for the user, all of these steps that you have to go through to move from one country to another. Now, contrast this with SSI and a digital wallet. All you need to do to enter another country is take your phone and scan that QR code and then say, yes, I want to use my digital credential, and you're done. The whole thing is to make it very simple and at the same time, very secure and very private. Now, another example. This is an example of a French citizen that wants to open up a bank account in the United Kingdom, in Britain. And these are all the different parties and services that have to talk to each other to accomplish that using federated identity today. If you want to contrast that with SSI, it's this simple. The French government issues a credential into your wallet. And when you want to go to the UK bank, they show us, they show a QR code, you scan it and share that credential, and you're done. This is why SSI is a dramatically simpler solution to internet identity. Now, it's even more so because that same credential you get from the French government, you can use for all of these different purposes. Exactly the same way I can take the credentials in this wallet and use them for any verifier or relying party, you know, merchant or bank, healthcare institution that will accept that. And of course, you can get credentials from many different sources and then use them with many different verifiers. And you get all of these benefits. So that's the basic reason to be excited about self-sovereign identity and how it's going to change our lives as individuals, consumers, and also the businesses and the governments we're interacting with. Now, last thing I'm going to show you is just quickly summarize what's in the book, and then we will move to question and answer. So there are four major sections of the book. The first one is the introduction. We cover all the basics, why we need it, and the building blocks. We give a set of scenarios of how this would work between Bob and Alice. And then we have a whole chapter that summarizes the major features and benefits for different for individuals and businesses. In the second part of the book, we do explain the technology through these seven chapters. We go into quite some depth. There's over 150 pages of information that covers all of these subjects, including decentralized identifiers, digital wallets and agents, cryptographic key management, and governance frameworks. In part three, we talk about the impact of SSI on society and politics, where it came from, how it's changing, how it fits with things like Web3 and the blockchain movement, and specifically how it will intersect with money, currency, both fiat or physical currency and digital currency. And then in the last part, we talk specifically about use cases, business cases for using SSI, how it would work with IoT, in animal care is one fascinating, voting and democracy, healthcare, and then two examples of countries that are already moving into it, both Canada and then, as I mentioned, the EU. So that's a quick summary. It's a 500 pages of a lot of information about SSI. And we had more that could fit into the book itself. The physical book, which I have a copy of right here, even that much, it couldn't all fit in there. So we have what's called the live book edition. When you buy either the digital or the physical version, you can also get access to another 11 chapters of additional information. So that's what I wanted to cover to just you know, set the stage. And now I'm going to stop sharing. And so we can just now do question and answer. And I'm trying to look here. The only